So when thinking about blood sugar and what's good, what's bad, what's really dangerous, as I said, when your blood sugars are higher, you're more likely over many years to develop some of the complications in the eyes and the kidneys and the nervous system. If your blood sugars get over 200, and certainly over 300, then there's an immediate problem, and that's related to losing that sugar through the kidneys. The kidneys actually protect the body from having a sugar that's too high by spilling that sugar in the urine. And that'll make you urinate more. That'll make you thirsty. And so if you have diabetes and you're urinating more than usual and you're thirsty, and this may go on for days, and then you're hungry and you're losing weight even though you're eating more, those are terrible signs, and you need to check your sugar immediately, because your sugar might be 300 or 400 or 500. Now, what's the danger there? Well, the danger is obviously over the long run, you're even more likely to get the complications. But in the short run, in the immediate days where your sugar is that high, you're becoming dehydrated and you're losing salts from the body through the kidney is along with the sugar. And many abnormalities in your metabolism are building up rapidly. And you can end up in coma. And the difference between type 1s and type 2s, patients with type 1 or type 2 diabetes, they can both go into coma. Type 1s are much more likely to do that. There are some chemical differences, but a type 2 diabetic can go into diabetic coma, and it can be a deadly outcome. So you need to know when your sugars are over 250 or 300, or certainly over 300, you're going to be urinating more and drinking more. And that means you're out of control. And you need to think about why you're out of control. Most common reasons are that you've gone off your diet, that you're eating the wrong foods. More likely though, you have an infection. Could be a urinary tract infection. It could be a virus that causes gastroenteritis with nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. It just could be the flu, and that kicks your glucose out of whack, even though you were well controlled. So these are all the reasons to keep checking your glucose at least several times a week when things are steady, and when things don't appear steady, to check them even more so. Do you need to see a doctor when your sugars are in the 200 to 300s? Well, yes, you should at least call the doctor and get some advice from the doctor or the doctor's staff, the diabetes nurse educator, about what's going on, what you feel. Are you infected with a virus or a bacterial infection? Do you need more diabetes medications? If you're on insulin, do you need more insulin? Those are the things they'll want to know, and maybe based on what you'll tell them, they'll want you to come to the office. Should you call 911? Not usually, because you should be seeing your doctor well before you can't get out of bed or you're so sick that you can't move. So prevention here of the terrible extreme situation is what you want to do.